Hello, I'm Krishna Raghavendran. So we are going to learn MIT App Inventor. So what is MIT App Inventor? MIT App Inventor is used to code using blocks and to make mobile apps. So let's start making our first app. So now you know what App Inventor is. Let's go to the site. The site is appinventor.mit.edu. I have given the link in the description. So you need to click on create apps and you need to log in with your Google account. If you don't have a Google account, you can create a Google account. After you log in, you need to create a new project. So I have created a project called first app in MIT App Inventor and I have also logged in. So you need to go to My Projects and click Start New Project. So make sure that you put an underscore instead of a space, because you cannot put space in the project names. It will give an error message. So now this is the palette, this is the viewer, this is the components, and this is the properties. So in the viewer, we can see how our app looks. In the palette, we can see all the components are available in MIT App Inventor. And then in the components, you can see the components which you have used to make your app in this screen called screen 1. And then in the properties, every component has a property. So I'm going to drag a button. So you can see button in components. So to make it come in the middle, make sure in the screen you have put align horizontal as center and align vertical as center. If you put it as left, it will go to the left of the horizontal. And if now I'll put center, and now you can see the button. So you can drag as many components you want into the screen. Now let's see what the properties window is. So we are going to change the properties of screen 1. So here you can see the app name. I have put first app. Here I have not put underscore because you can put space and it will not give an error. The difference between the app name and the project name is that the project name will be visible only to us who will program, and the app name will be visible to the users who are using your app. So I'll put first app, and then you can change the background color of the screen. I'll put it as orange of screen 1. You can put an upload and background image, and there are many other things. You can make the title visible. You can see the title. You can also change the title. So now I'm going to change the font size of this button in the properties window to 20. Now it looks better. I'll make it bold. I'll change it to change color. Yes. So now I'm going to change the color of the button to green, and there you go, you have a button. You can change the height and the width. So if I put 10% of the height, it will occupy 10% of the mobile screen in the height. If I put 100%, it will occupy the whole height. Instead of 100%, you can also put fill parent, which means the same. So I'm going to put 10%, and our button looks good. So now let's start programming. You need to go to the blocks. This is the designer where you design your app, and this is the blocks where you do some programming, how the app works. So now we are going to do a simple app in which when they click a button, the change color button, the background will get changed to any color. I'll put blue. So if you want, you can rename the button. I'm not going to rename it. Let it be as button 1. So in the blocks section, these are the built-in blocks which are already there, and these are the component blocks. So now I'm going to, every component has its own blocks. For example, screen 1 has its own blocks like this, and button 1 has its own blocks. So I'm going to drag this block. This means that when button 1, which is this button, when it is clicked, dot click do. So here we need to put what the app needs to do when the user clicks button, the button. So now in this app, we are going to change the background of screen 1. So to change the background of screen 1, you need to go to the screen 1 blocks. Here you have many blocks. Here you have set screen 1 dot background image. I'm sorry, it's background color. So now it shows an error because we didn't put what color here. It shows the error as 1. When you click, it shows this block needs a value block connected to its socket. So this is the socket of the block. So set screen 1 dot background color to blue. So in the built-in blocks, if you go to colors, you have many other colors, and you can also make the color using RGB code. So I'm going to put blue. If you want to change the color, you don't need to again go here. You can just click here and you can see a whole lot of colors available. So now our coding is done. So how can we test the app? So before that, I want to tell a small thing. If you want a block, you can just type the block's name. So for example, if I want this true block, I can type TR, and here you can see true, and just click instead of searching here. And here you can put it in the dustbin if you don't need, or you can right click and click on delete two blocks, how much blocks you want. You can duplicate the blocks. Now I don't want this one. And you can add comments so that if you give your app to somebody else, they could understand well. And you can also download the blocks as PNG. The image will get saved. So now to test your app, you need to go to connect. So we are going to connect AI Companion app in the mobile. So first, for this you need MIT AI Companion app. It should be downloaded in the mobile. So if you click here, AI Companion, you can scan a QR code. Or if you build your app, you can, again, there'll be a QR code, and if you scan, the app will be downloaded in the mobile. The difference between building and connecting is, if you do connecting, you can do live testing, which means that you don't need to install again and again. For example, if I put a label here, you don't need to install again in the mobile. It will automatically appear so that we can test easily. So now we are going to do AI Companion. So now I'm going to click on connect AI Companion, and you'll get a QR code which we will scan using the mobile. You cannot scan with any QR code app available. You need to scan with the MIT AI2 Companion on your device. So now you have the MIT AI2 Companion app, which you can get in Google Play Store. I have given the link in the description. So now let's go to MIT AI2 Companion and click on scan QR code. So now I have scanned the QR code in the computer. So it takes some time to connect. It will also show the percentage. Now here you can see our app.
we can see the change color button, and if you put a label here, you can see it automatically appears. You don't need to install again. So this app is, this MIT AI2 Companion is for testing purposes. So now I'm going to click on change color. You can see the color is changed to blue. So now our app works. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe.